Good evening, doctors. Our today's topic is hypoglycemia. I'm going to write hypoglycemia. So, my dear friend, what does it mean? Hypo means low. Hypo means low, if you take hypo. And glycemia means glucose. And emia means emia. I-M-I-A means blood. So, this spelling by their own telling us, hypo means low, glycemia means glucose, and emia means blood. Low blood glucose level. So we have to know what is the normal values and when we consider a hypoglycemia. So my dear friends, in hypoglycemia, firstly the definition is low blood glucose level. Hypoglycemia is not any topic, is not any diagnose. Hypoglycemia is just a condition. It's just a condition when the serum sugar level goes down in this situation. So pathologically, so I'm going to tell you about some symptoms, what happens when our sugar level of body is going down and how to identify. So symptoms I'm going to write SX, like sweating, excess sweat during hypoglycemia, tachycardia, palpitation, anxiety, these are the symptoms. Sometimes seizures, very very severe hypoglycemia, ALOC, acute loss of consciousness, patient fall down, loses his consciousness, but in severe cases. Sometimes a patient is dull, dry skin, lost turgor, dry skin, severely dehydrated. These are the symptoms, and he's seeing blurred vision, not able to see properly. So symptoms, my dear friends, and some behavior changes, fatigue, nausea, vomiting, it include and nausea. We hear vomiting, fatigue, tired, not able to do any activity. So my dear friend, these all are the symptoms. Tremors come. Sometimes tremors like this, palpitation, anxiety, nausea, blurred vision, behavior changes. But here, in case of hypoglycemia, what we are not going to find? No ketone bodies, no ketones in urine, no polyuria, no polydipsia. So my dear friends, and no glycosuria in urine, absent. Maybe positive, maybe present in rare situation, mostly not. But symptoms are same, sweat, tachycardia, palpitation. Now I am going to explain you the causes. What caused the hypoglycemia like condition? What are the causes? I hope till here, what is hypoglycemia, clear? Symptoms of hypoglycemia, it's also clear. Okay, so I am going to explain the causes why this hypoglycemia like condition occurs. My dear friends, I'm going to tell you this way. Cause like medications, which medications? Anti-hyperglycemic. Which one? Mainly sulfonylurea. Sulfonylurea causes hypoglycemia. Example, glimepiride, gliclazide, glibenclamide, chlorpropamide. These are the medication which causes hypoglycemia. What else? Insulin. Insulin, if we are giving some kinds more doses, it causes hypoglycemia. Hypoglycemia. And what else? Factitious insulin. Just factitious insulin. What does it mean? Maybe some patient is psychiatric who suffer from type 1 diabetes mellitus and he inject by their own huge dose and he comes under hypoglycemia. Sometimes another cause, infections. Infections also, sugar level goes down in case of infections. Insulinoma. Insulinoma. What does it mean by insulinoma? It is a tumor of pancreas. Tumor of pancreas. What does it happen in this? A beta cell produce more insulin. More insulin in case of insulinoma. So what happens? And proinsulin, I am going to explain you what does it mean by, firstly the proinsulin, then two products break down insulin, another one plus C-peptide. So all these three increases in case of insulinoma. Insulinoma, all these three increases. And what other causes, like dumping syndrome after gastrectomy? Dumping syndrome can cause hypoglycemia. Why dumping syndrome can cause? Because nothing is because food came in the mouth and so fast in the intestine, so no time for absorption there. That's why it causes hypoglycemia. And what are the other causes? In case of hypothyroidism also there is hypoglycemia. And in case of liver disease, LD means liver disease. Why in liver disease there is hypoglycemia? Because what was the work of liver? Liver do gluconeogenesis. So if liver is not working properly, no gluconeogenesis in case of liver disease. And liver is also responsible for glycolysis. What happens when glucose breaks down? The body will get glucose, but in such situation no glucose. In case of ethanol toxicity also condition hypoglycemia. Why in ethanol toxicity? Because ethanol damage the liver functions. That's why there is also a breakdown and hypoglycemia occurs. And also in case of Addison disease, my dear friends, I'm going to explain all these disease in different session, but here I'm going to explain you why hypoglycemia occurs. Because here decreased cortisol levels. When there is a decrease in cortisol level, that's why there is decrease in epinephrine and glucagon. There is decrease in epinephrine and glucagon. So my dear friends, till here I hope clear all these causes, and these are very much important. So many times, so many examinations they asking such questions. So please try to understand it and try to remember. These are very easy, and you are able to save the life of a person if you know this situation. Okay, now I am going to explain something, my dear friends. So that is very much interesting. I am going to take hypoglycemia. How to diagnose? So firstly we take here like insulinoma here, and here exogenous insulin. Exogenous from outside, insulin exogenous. And here we take sulfonylurea. Sulfonylurea, what does they do? Sulfonylurea endogenous producing insulin, endogenous activating the insulin. So if we talk about serum insulin level in case of insulinoma, I already told insulinoma proinsulin. Firstly remember, increases proinsulin increases insulinoma. So it breaks down into insulin plus C-peptide. So, serum insulin increase in insulinoma? Yes. If we give exogenous insulin outside drug, so the serum insulin level increases in our body? Yes, of course, yes. And sulfonylurea, endogenous increase the insulin level. So here also serum insulin level increases, my dear friends. But if we are going to talk about C-peptide, in case of insulinoma, C-peptide also increases because proinsulin increases and is breakdown. But in case of exogenous insulin, proinsulin level is normal. We are injecting outside insulin, only insulin we are injecting, artificial preparation. That's why what is going to happen? Here C-peptide, because there is no breakdown of C-peptide. So here the C-peptide, what is going to happen? It's being normal or sometimes low. Okay, in case of sulfonylurea, is it endogenous insulin level? So what was going to happen? Endogenous insulin level, so C-peptide also increases here. But now we are going to talk about proinsulin. What was going to happen with proinsulin? Please come, bring camera near. Here. What happens with proinsulin? Proinsulin also increases in here, but in case here normal or maybe decrease. And what was going to be happen? Here it's normal and going to be present. And if we see the urine sugar, what was going to happen? Here urine sugar going to be normal, because no urine sugar, so we can say no. And here also exogenous insulin, so no urine sugar here, no urine sugar. And here sulfonylurea, urine sugar may be present. I hope till here you, it's clear for you. So now I am going to teach you what are the levels and how to treat these hypoglycemic conditions. And you know, in my practice I already seen such cases. So what is going to treat? What when the sugar level fasting we are going to consider 170 till 120 is normal. But 70 till 120 is normal blood sugar fasting. But in case of less than 70 sugar, patient may be asymptomatic, but in some cases he must be symptomatic, which I already told. So it's mild hypoglycemia. If less than 50, it's moderate hypoglycemia. If less than 35, it's severe hypoglycemia. So in case of mild hypoglycemia, we can give like chocolates, like 2 TSF sugar, or chocolate, like toffees, some Cadbury, okay, candies, not Cadbury. In moderate, we can give sometimes IV dextrose, 25% or 50%. But in case of severe, we need to give always 50% IV dextrose. And that will end fluid balance also. If patient is dehydrated, so we are going to hydrate the fluid balance in such a case. I hope, my dear friend, this is understand for you. Now it's a time for questions, and I'm going to ask some questions. Okay, a patient present with symptoms of hypoglycemia. Patient present with symptom of hypoglycemia. Investigation reveals decreased blood glucose. Yes, blood glucose decreases. And increase in insulin level. Insulin levels are increases, but blood glucose level decreases. Insulin increases, blood glucose decreases. Okay, insulin C-peptide assay is done, which shows the normal level, but C-peptide is normal. The most likely diagnosis is options are, first one is insulinoma, B is accidental sulfonylurea injection, C is accidental exogenous insulin administration, and D is accidental metformin ingestion. So my question goes to Dr. Emily. Please answer
D.
Now this time he is wrong, because answer here is C. This time you have to wake up in my class. Accidental exogenous insulin administration. Okay, another question. Down phenomena refers to, option A is early morning hyperglycemia, option B is early morning hypoglycemia, option C is hypoglycemia followed by hyperglycemia, option D is high insulin levels. So what is Down phenomena? My question goes to Dr. Lal Singh. Please answer. Yeah, this time he is absolutely right. Early morning hyperglycemia. Yes, this one is right. Factitious hyperinsulinemia is differentiated from insulinoma by option A, C-peptide. No, option A is insulin bodies. Option D is proinsulin. Option C is serum glucose level. Option D is C-peptide. My question goes to Dr. Emily. Please answer.
C.
Wrong this time. C-peptide. Yeah, C-peptide is answer. Option is D. Okay. Down phenomena refers to, okay, again repeatedly asked, next question. Antabuse like effect caused by oral hypoglycemic drug. Okay, options are Acabose, and option B is metformin, option D is glycyrrhizide, option C is glycyrrhizide, option D is chlorpropamide. My question goes to Dr. Emily. Again, answers. Please answer, which option is it? Which one?
C.
Wrong this time. D is the option. What happened with you? You have to prepare. This time you are not ready. Okay. Answer is chlorpropamide. So, my dear friends, that's all. Our today's session is completed. I hope you got a lot of knowledge with my lecture. And in my next coming videos, I am going to explain type 1 diabetes, type 2 diabetes mellitus, and their complications like DKA, like HHS, and microvascular, macrovascular complications in my further videos. If you haven't watched my lecture like about insulin, so you see that lecture also. And my target to explain you all subjects, all 23 subjects together. So, my dear friends, that's all for today. Have a good night, good day. Well done. Thank you.